And on our next part of the tour, we will stand here and stare at the ocean for approximately 20 minutes. I'm kidding. Our next place on our farewell tour is a pretty special one to me. A lot of people have been here. A lot of people know it just from this tunnel and from what they can see in the distance. We are in the Rhines region. And Master Rhines is no longer here with us on Crazy Pig. But his build still remain. And that's a wonderful thing. Because to lose this would be a loss of pure build genius. He brought me here, and my jaw just dropped. The time, the effort, the artistic talent, the dedication that it would take to do all of this, that's a player. And one, and his trademark trees, a Rhines tree. Part of me wants to copy this and make some of these. But I got to tell you, I feel that if I were to copy that, I don't think there's any way to, not sure if there's any way to make it my own. You know, and the last thing I want is people coming along and saying, oh, look, is that a Rhines tree? No, it's not a Rhines tree. It was me trying to make a Rhines tree. So, you know, Master Rhines, thanks for this. I could spend a lot of time here. This would be a tour in and of itself. That's a trademark. Master Rhines thing right there, the creeper face, and you'll see those in a lot of his builds. No matter where you go here, Lanica, Cambria, when you see one of those, yeah, it's pretty much instantaneous. This was, this is a memory here. We were discussing the hopper cap and stuff, and we spent a good bit of time fiddling around trying to think of a way around it. I'll be honest. Can't hold anything back here. But I love how it just goes from like this, I don't know, rustic style over here to like this modern spaceshipy kind of thing. And he has another island build somewhere, and I'm sorry to say, folks, he never showed it to me. I never asked. I forgot. And I don't know where it's at. So if any of you know where it's at, please go there, write down the coordinates, leave me a message on the Crazy Pig homepage, or if you see me online, send me a message. But, I would love, because I'm going to come around to all these places quickly before, and I'm not going to do it now. I'm going to take screenies with coordinates, because that's what you're going to have to do. You know, find your favorite places, take screenies with coordinates, and you can come back to them when the world's available for download. But, oh, the sorting systems, man. Holy pool noodles. Just, that's nuts. That's just nuts. But it's fantastic, and it's amazing. Oh, my gosh. Wow. I messed around here quite a bit, man. Traded with his villagers. You know, just hung out, talked stuff. And, wow. You know, just, it was a thing, man. It's real, man. This is real. Can't help it. Gotta be real. So, folks, we're gonna, move on in our little part of the tour here. So, we will exit the Rhines region, and we are walking into the sunset. The sunset of Cambria. We are walking. Ladies and gentlemen, crazy pigs of all ages, our next stop of the Memory Tour brings us to New Haven. Now, of course, I just did a video on New Haven not too long ago, but I can't, do this farewell tour without coming here. Of course, we all know this is owned by GamePar, and this is GamePar's house. He even has a garage, man. That just tells you how much GamePar gets paid for doing this. Just kidding. We're all doing it on a volunteer basis. Now, here we go. Creeper Face. Rhine's Build. Of course. But I'm going to try and, kind of do a quick breeze thing here. I'm definitely headed for One Direction. And I'm sure when, GamePar watches this, he knows where I'm going. Because I can't resist him. Why is this skeleton out in the daylight? He knows I can't resist going here because... it was another one of those places that when I saw it, it blew my mind. My jaw, literally, yeah, I'm going to get lost again. I do this every time I mess up. Oh, I didn't. Cool. Here we have a Rhine's tree, which is growing next to, ladies and gentlemen, the one, the only, the Creeper Dome. This is pretty much why I came here on our Memories tour, because when I saw this, did my jaw drop. I was like, holy pool noodles times 10. The amount of work, and from what I'm told, and GamePar will definitely correct me in-game when he sees me if I am wrong, he has rebuilt this several times. Worlds moving worlds, and whatnot. I'm gonna say 4 or 5, and GamePar, feel free to, scold me in the game next time I'm on. But man, the work, the time. That's nuts. That's just awesomeness. The parking garage. The tower. Excuse me. Oh, I haven't had lunch yet. And I think I should be getting to that pretty soon. But, yeah, that's just, and speaking of GamePar, I hope you guys are watching his videos. He's doing a fantastic job. I really enjoy watching GamePar's videos. His basic, Valor Survival. And I didn't call it Valor for once. he kind of yelled at me a little bit the other day. He says, Buck, why do you keep referring to Valor as a piece of fabric? And I'm like, I'm sorry, I'm trying to break that habit. I keep calling it Valor because of the spelling. I'll get it. Please be patient. So, that kind of, like I said, since I did a video here not too long ago, I'm not going to spend a whole lot of time here. Rhine's. But we're going to move on to the next part of the tour. And, so therefore we are walking. The next part of our tour will be fairly brief, I assure you, but it is a memory nonetheless. While out exploring, I found this ice spikes biome, and I said, oh, I love ice spikes biomes, and they're so rare. And I tried to set up a castle. I tried to get a castle thing going here. And for the life of me, what I was going to do was I was going to, have this sticking out of the rock, and I was going to go into the mountainside, sort of like a, dwarven kind of thing. And, for the life of me, I couldn't make it happen. I couldn't make it flow. I was trying, I was struggling, and I kind of figured, when you struggle that hard, maybe it's better to just put it down and walk away, and maybe something will happen. And who knows? Maybe once it's available for download, something will happen, and I can finish it and maybe show you. But while I was here, I told Master Rhine's about it, and here comes a little baby zombie villager, and you're cute, but guess what? You're gone. And, of course, he thought it was cool, so he moved in next to me. And in typical Rhine's fashion, builds himself a neat little place. This one with an Asian type feel to it. You know, awesomeness. I gotta figure out how to do that. Those corner things are cool. I love Asian architecture anyway. I love pagodas and things like that. And yeah, the corner thing. But here's the thing that stinks. We couldn't get to the rest of the ice spikes biome because of the world border. And ooh, that makes the screen go weird red. Yeah, the world border is right here. Man, it's like, we were like, bummer, because the it went on farther. We don't know how much further it would have went on for. Because there's really actually not a whole lot of the ice spike biome here. We just kind of caught the tip of it. But nonetheless, lighting, this is a lighting glitch, I'm pretty sure. Yep, I think if you put a torch on it, yeah, see, because I have the torch thing on Optifine. Yeah, that's an interesting lighting effect, because that one there I built. I tried building it, and I tried kind of copying it. I think I did a pretty fair job, I must say. But yeah, I couldn't get that to happen. That kind of does it on its own. So I told you this part would be brief because there's really not much to see. But I love the ice spikes biome, so I thought I would share that with you. So for the last and probably final part of the tour, we are walking. And our next part brings us to this lovely hill in a swamp, which we are going to observe closely. I'm just kidding. Actually, I'm facing this way because what I want to show you is behind me and I didn't want to ruin it. It was more for the dramatic effect. So if we turn around, you will see this. Now, there is quite some story to this. Let me begin from the beginning. Lady Tia, 1402, I believe it is, and staff member, and I were exploring Cambria one day, looking for a place for her to live. And she explained to me that she's rather picky. So we'd spent quite a bit of time flying around. And she was out ahead of me. And she just said, "Whoa, Buck." I said, "Whoa, what?" And she said, "You gotta see this." And we came upon this castle. Now, not all of this was original, and we'll get to that. You can pretty much see the wooden tippy top thingies here. That is where the original castle is. Now, one of the more amazing parts about all this was we checked this from top to bottom, front to back, above and below. And none of it, not one block, was claimed. And we couldn't believe it. So, we asked Sully the Unusual, who was owner at the time, can we have it? Would that be legit? And he said, "Well, it's not claimed. Go ahead." And because the thought in our mind was, we would hate to see this, somebody come along and grief this, wreck it, just take this beautiful, beautiful work and just totally destroy it. So here's where I ask you, the players, a question. If anyone at all knows who built this castle, please tell me in game or send me a message on the Crazy Pig website, because we have no idea. It could be a player long gone. It could be a player who built it and just decided to abandon it. And that's nuts. Now the ballista, I added that later, and I think that's pretty cool. And I thought I did a pretty decent job on it. I figure it's a big castle. It needs, we'll get over there later. It needs needs defense. So yeah, I made a ballista. Pretty cool. So the problem therefore was this. None of us really had the available claim blocks to build it or to claim it. And in reality, and I get the directions all screwed up every time I come over here. So a staff member at the time, TK1, we showed him, and he said, oh yeah, he started claiming part of it. And kind of the idea was, well, we'll all claim little parts and kind of everybody share. And that was about the only way we could do it. Now, Lady Tia decided to pitch camp here. And I'm getting bombarded by a skeleton. Excuse. Oh, I do not want to hit one of her horses. Ooh, no, no, no. She'll skin me alive. Get over here, you rotten little... There you go. Now, that little house over there... Yeah, that's mine. I built that because I didn't have the claim blocks either. So I figured I'd live over here until I could save up the blocks. And TK1 took part of it. And, you know, I was just kind of hanging out here doing my thing. And I think I featured this in some of my videos. So, but anyway, I needed the claim blocks. And I asked one of the other staff members, Magic G Master, if she wanted to buy it, and she said she would. She needed another place. She never moved in, so I am of the opinion that she was just doing a really nice thing. Why are all the horses shaking their feet? Man, the horses are getting down with it, getting down with it, getting down with it. Let's do the horsey dance. Okay, that's my Minecraft ADD kicking in again. Nevertheless... So, somebody added on to that later. I think TK1 got a person who was no longer staff here, and I can't remember her. Sketching Blue, that's it. Woohoo, memory lane wins. She built that. But eventually the point came up where TK1 left, and it was open. So, I talked to fellow staff member Nika Knight. And he came over, and we all started, we managed to get it all. We managed to nail it. We got it. And he started doing his thing over here. And look out for all the spooters. He started, get out of my face. Nike Knight started doing his thing over here. He even built himself a little archery practice range. Let's see how I do. Bada bing! We have a winner. Buy that lady a prize. Nika Knight even made a portcullis in his castle, and if you press the button, it doesn't work. I guess it's broken. What good is a castle that doesn't have a working portcullis? Nika Knight, what are you doing? Now I have to fly. Just ruined the whole effect, man. Way to bring down the vibe in the room, man. Did a great job, though, as Nike Knight usually does. Oh, hello. Goodbye. So he began working on a villager village over here. And in the process of conversation, another fellow staff member, we told you, we were all getting in on this, man. Another fellow staff member, Darren_GA, he came over and took a look, and he said, wow, I have some ideas. Now, so I gave him perms, and in originality, he began expanding and working on it. In originality, the original throne room, I think went like right about to here. It wasn't very big. It wasn't very big at all. And the stairs, you know, going upstairs. And I'm going to try not to turn this into a big tour, because this the castle is nuts, I'm telling you. But what the original throne looked pretty much like this. And it even had this little thing here. And this throne where you flick the switch, the throne pulls back. And that was over up toward the front. And then there was like, you know, the storage area. It came right down to here where the ladder is. And I'm not going to break the block to show you. Now, I'm going to try and be quick about this. I'm really going to try to be quick, because we don't want to... This castle is huge. There's a spot here that... Oh, way to go. I added on to later. Because this was one of my forays into Redstone. You press the button. And secret staircase to the dungeon area where I was putting in storage. I thought I did a pretty decent job here. This was like my most... usually when I set up storage, chest storage like this, I just kind of stack them and put wood between them. And I don't get real fancy. But I was trying to go for the theme, you know. And I even made a villager with a torture. I know, it's a torture rack. I'm sorry, I shouldn't have done that. But that was my idea of a torture rack and the villagers. And yeah, I thought this was pretty good. And this was where I learned a neat little trick where if you put a stone slab on an item frame and then place a torch somewhere here along the edges or whatever, it'll pop right in there. And that looks like a torch in a holder. Is that not cool or what? If you don't know that one, that trick, folks, there you go. Right there, you're looking at it. So let's get back up out of here. That was not here originally. I added on to that. But this was here. And this goes down to a deep mine. And there was a mine cart that was just constantly going back and forth, back and forth. And what you can do is down at the bottom, you can load up a chest with items, and when the mine cart comes back, it'll load them up and it'll bring them up here and it'll dump the items in the chest like so. And there's some pumpkin pie, and while I'm here and I have the pumpkin pie, I think I'll just you know, what do you think, folks? We'll see if I can make a messy rocker eating face. Nom 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 nom. Yes, there we go, messy pumpkin pie face. I love it. Okay, anyway, I'm getting out of control. So Sam come along and he rewired it down below so that the cart doesn't bounce back and forth all the time, because that helps cut down on lag. So Darren GA and So Darren GA added to the throne room, and he was not upset, but he was rather disappointed that a castle of this type, didn't have a great room. He said all castles have a great room because Darren GA is like the castle man. You want a castle, Darren GA is your man. So he made a great room and explained to me what a great room was. It was where all the heroes came to dine and party and get down with it. And what he tried to do was, and I really appreciate this greatly, was that he tried to keep it in the same style. He studied this carefully. He studied the original part. And, I don't know what you guys think, but I think he did a fantastic job at just really blending it in. He blended it in really well. He did an amazing job. It looks like it's always been there. And that's, you know, part of the greatness that it is. And I hung out here a lot. You know, once I found this place, this was next to my storage base. This was pretty much my home here in Cambria. I mean, because why not? I mean, oh, yes, there was other things. So some of the other staff members, I built this bridge. Figured that looked kind of nice because I kind of deemed this a, like, fishing location, a fishing dock. Because there were no boats here, and it's kind of deep to be putting boats in, so I figured it was a fishing dock. So I built a bridge to get over to the fishing dock, and there is a creeper. Let's do an axe this time, right? So one of the other staff members, Lethal Discord, we told him about this area. He was impressed. We were trying to make like a staff retreat area. And he came over and he built himself something. Now, it looks as if, you know, Lethal Discord's into the whole same, this Asian style architecture. And Lethal, I'm going to go ahead and go inside. Please forgive me for being nosy. I love it with the wool blocks. Kind of gives it a paper wall door effect thing. Fantastic. This is great. I mean, it looks great, you know. Deck it out in your, you know, your furniture and things of that nature. And boy, this would look really good. This is nice, Lethal. Fantastic job. Well, what can I say? I'm going to fly over here to the... I'm just going to fly here to the front door. Because, you know, this looks like about a good place. Yeah, let's see. Turn around and figure out... There we go. There we go. That's what I'm looking for. Walk up a little bit here. No, hopefully I don't walk right into the water. I'm not good in the F5 mode. Hey, guys, you know what? Thanks so much for watching this video. I had a lot of fun coming back around, looking at these places, talking about these places. And I hope you saw something of yours in here. But these are the places that were special to me and held memories for me while I played here in Cambria. And all the adventures I had and all the people I hung out with here too, as well as I did over in Atlantica. And the best part about it is they're all squashed together in Valor now. So it won't be, you know, hey, come to here. Hey, come over here. We're all one big happy, you know, pig pen over there, right? But this is great. Wow. I really like it. This is the place to end up. I don't know. I'm usually not at a loss for words, and I'm usually kind of goofy, and I'm trying to be. I'm trying not to be sad. This isn't sad. This is just a lot of good times coming back to my mind, and I'm trying to be real here. So, you know what? I'm gonna go ahead and call it quits for now. Thanks so much again for watching. I really hope you enjoy the video. So everybody, we'll see you over in Valor. Be good. Be safe. And I got my eye on you.